To start setting up your pay per gigabyte ISP proxies, go to ISP Proxies and click here. First, you'll see the authentication methods section. You can authenticate your proxies in two ways. First, let's see how the username password authentication method works. As you can see, a user with a username and password has been created for you automatically. You can copy the username to your clipboard by clicking on it. You may copy your password the same way. To see the password, click on the crossed out eye icon. By pressing this button, you'll generate a new password for your user. If you want to set a traffic limit for a user, click on Set Limit. Once you're satisfied with the amount, press the check mark. To delete a user, click the trash bin icon, then confirm delete. Create a new user by pressing Create User. Note that when creating a user, you'll be able to name the user as you wish. The password will be generated automatically. You can also authenticate ISPs via IP whitelisting. Click on Whitelisted IP. Now you can either add an IP manually or quickly add your current one to the whitelisted IP list. Note that you can only add IPs that are in IPv4 format. Also, make sure that the IP you're adding is yours and that you aren't using a proxy or VPN service at the time. Click here to name your whitelisted IP. If you want to remove it, simply press Delete and Confirm Delete. Let's move to the Endpoint Generator block. First, if you have multiple users, select one, or choose a whitelisted IP. Then select your preferred location. After that, select your session type. If you choose a static session, your IP will stay the same until you use the same port. Once you change your port, the IP will change, and you'll start a new static session. If you choose the rotating session, your IP will change automatically with every new connection request. Then select your preferred protocol. You can set a maximum number of endpoints, download the created proxy list, or copy it to your clipboard. Now let's see how to integrate the proxies into your code. Click here to see integration examples in different coding languages. Press Copy to copy the code. To track your proxy usage, go to the Statistics block. Here you can see the traffic usage of each user over a week, a month, or over your chosen period. You can also see the total uploads, downloads, and requests. Apply the proxy endpoint, port, and if required, credentials to any application or tool. Here's an example of what it looks like on a simple curl command using the rotating ISP port. As you can see, the IP changes on each request, meaning the test is successful. For guides on how to integrate our proxies, visit our documentation.